Next, we head to ArtCube to check out the three exhibits that are currently housed within that space. Watch this. Different galleries offers unique art experiences. Its interiors, including the placement of lights, walls, and even windows, play a vital role in creating the mood for an art exhibit.
Originality, and of course, you can't miss creativity and skill, but lately we've been looking for a lot of artists with wit and very good visual narratives.
ArtCube houses 2 to 3 exhibits every month. As a safety protocol, they can only accommodate a maximum of 15 people. This March, it will showcase 3 artists whose works narrate stories from the past in an attempt to immortalize them in the present.
The artists are very, of course, very diverse, but I'm getting a lot of walk-ins here that they're saying it feels very nostalgic, the shows in the gallery now, as if it was curated to have them do a show all together and have their theme like sentimental.
One of the exhibits was Jonathan Hoven's Square Meters. Through the use of repurposed architectural blueprints as grounds for his paintings, Hoven tells the story of his past desire to own a home, despite and because of the conditions that he faced while living in the slums of Tondo, Manila. Anchored on heavy truths on class inequality and poverty, Hoven's paintings exude grit, angst, and surprisingly warmth. His use of color and delicate brushstrokes led the viewers into an interesting art exploration. At the center of the space lies a captivating installation that is made of soil, wood, stones, and cement. It's amazing how these construction materials that we normally see everywhere, when arranged together, evokes a feeling that one might carry even after leaving the gallery. Steps away from the exhibit hang multiple black and white paintings that comprise Azer Pascoguing's solo exhibit Noon. Through a monochromatic color palette, Azer features portraits of artists, equipment, and legends from the past. Azer's attention to detail and undeniable skill in working with canvas shed new light on the outdated glory of old objects and almost forgotten legends. The last exhibit is Nick Navarro's eerie exploration on the idea of superstitions. Nick set up an altar-like installation comprised of items that are used to counter evil spirits in the traditional Filipino culture. But the most haunting aspect of the exhibit are his actual surreal and symbolic contemplations behind every artwork. In Sa Ating Pagkabusog Ay Di Na Muli Tayo Makukontento, the artist confronts the old superstition that one's soul departs from the body should one happen to fall asleep while hungry. Through his highly charged depiction of a room and a white silhouette of a man on the wall, he conveys how one's hunger for limitless knowledge can consume the soul. He also features today's current realities through his painting. With a perfect blend of warm and neutral colors, he painted the narrative of today's pandemic as if it were an old, ancient photograph. For the staff of ArtCube, the beauty of the space lies in the walls that have borne witness to the stories delivered by artists from across the country. And the ArtCube continues to provide space for artists who yearn to tell their stories through the gallery's walls.